This production is brought to you by the University of Edinburgh.
Hello, and welcome to an interactive introduction to MATLAB. This screencast will look at solutions to exercise 4, which was about plotting. Question 1 was about using the plot3 function, which is a built-in MATLAB function for plotting points and lines in 3D space. Question 1, Part A, a spherical helix. We're told that t ranges from 0 to 10 pi, so we'll define that using the Lin space function. We're also told that c equals 5, which will be the constant in our formulas. We then move on to defining x, y, and z. I can now use the plot3 function in a very similar manner to the plot function we have used in previous examples. And a figure window appears with a plot of a spherical helix. Part B is a sine wave on a sphere. We have some constraints to define and t to define between 0 and 2 pi. We now want to calculate x, y, and z. We'll just use the up arrow to reuse our plot3 function we used in part A. And with a tweak to the plot title, a plot appears showing the expected result. Question 2 is all about using the built-in function surf to plot surfaces in 3D space. Part A is plotting a sine surface. We therefore start by defining u and v according to the question, which are ranging between 0 and 2 pi. We now need to use the mesh grid function on our vectors u and v to create a grid of points which we can then calculate x, y, and z from. The output of mesh grid is going to be u and v, so it will overwrite our vectors with some new matrices. Our inputs are the vectors we have just created, u and v. Before I execute this command, we will look at the workspace and you will see that vectors u and v are row vectors containing 50 elements. After I execute this command, u and v will turn into matrices of 50 by 50 points, which we can then plot our function onto. Moving on, we now want to calculate x, y, and z. We now can plot our surface using the surf function. We also should label our axes and title the plot as normal. The question also tells us to use the shading and terp command, which basically improves the shading of the graph for display purposes. The last thing we are asked to do is add a color bar to the plot. These are very useful since it provides an easy visualization of the values of z. We do this by issuing the color bar command. The result then opens in a figure window and shows our sine surface plot. If you click on the icon in the toolbar labeled Rotate, you are able to move the plot and inspect it from all angles. If you then need to return to the previous view, you can use the Tools menu to select the Reset, which will return the plot to its original view. Part B is done in a similar fashion. This time, we are plotting a spring in 3D space, and we have some constraints we need to enter as well. Firstly, we use the mesh grid function to redefine U and V. Then we calculate X, Y, and Z. We can then use the up arrow to retrieve the plot command from the previous example. The result is a spring in 3D space. Finally, part C requires us to plot an elliptical torus. The result can be seen as an elliptical torus.
This production is copyright, the University of Edinburgh.